Well, welcome to the final episode of Colum and Collette's. This covers the years 1978, 79, and 80. They were getting quite short at this stage because children didn't want to partake in them, except John, of course. And there he is out in the yard of the bank, car park in the bank, building a snowman. And here we are out at Durley Park during the snow. I had built this little sleigh. So that's Rory pushing John along the riverside. Two immature swans. There's Durley Park. This stage, of course, Rory is 12, Maria is 10, and John would be 6. And now this is Rory's confirmation out at Carrow. That's Bishop Dominic Conway. There's Rory, looking very much the young man at the stage. Schoolmates, classmates. There's Colette with Rory and Maria. And that's John in the white cardigan taking a photograph. And here we are out at the yacht club in Ross's Point. And that's the sailboat that Mike has now. So it has stood the time well. That's Rosemary. She was visiting us at the moment, at that time. There we are, launching the boat from the slipway at the yacht club in Ross's Point. It's Rory and myself launching it. There we go. I think Colette must have been filming this from the shore. That's Coney Island we're sailing towards. And that's Rosemary and John and Hugo. That's Rory at the tiller sailing the boat. Knocknarea in the background there. So that was a short 1978, now we're into 1979. Up in the Giant's Causeway, Colette with Maria, and there's John up behind them. And that's Tony McBride, my brother. There's Rory, teenager now. And that's myself in the yellow jumper. And this is the aeroplane carrying the Pope to Ireland in 1979. There was over a million people gathered in the Phoenix Park in Dublin to attend the Mass and to welcome the Pope to Ireland. Well, that's Noel McHugh. There was a big crowd of us. We stayed in Uncle Hugh's house in Dublin the night before and walked up to the Phoenix Park before dawn. That was the Irish Air Force in the form of a cross that escorted the Pope. We landed in Dublin Airport and then came to the Phoenix Park in this helicopter. And the crowd went wild, waving their flags and cheering when the helicopter arrived. White box there is it's a periscope. They sold thousands of them so that people could see over the heads of the crowd. There's Uncle Hugh, and Noel McHugh standing beside him. We were a good bit away from the altar. But as I say, there was a million people there. It's about a quarter of the population of Ireland at the time. Here's the Pope coming. This is the closest I ever got to a Pope. He's in his Pope-mobile, blessing the crowd and acknowledging their cheers as he passed. I had John sitting on my shoulders at the time. This is the crowd dispersing, I think, yes. That was a short 1979, now we're into 1980. And this is in February 1980 when Colette and myself and Rory and Marie and John went for a holiday to Mallorca. We drove to London and got a plane from London to Mallorca. It's Maria. So this is having lunch in one of the roadside cafes. Maybe just a cup of coffee or a drink. There's John and Maria and Rory and myself. Rory looks a bit bored, doesn't he? This is back at the swimming pool outside the hotel. Maria just after jumping in. Well, that was me jumping in, diving in there. It's Rory. So that's John holding on to me. It's Rory swimming with John on his back. Oh no, it was me, sorry. And this is in the balcony outside the room that we had in the hotel. I think we must have bought in lunch. See a sliced pan there, so we made some sandwiches. That's the hotel that we stayed in. down on the beach. Well, we thought it was great. We were in our bathing togs and sunbathing in the beach. But the German tourists were walking the beach in fur coats. And this was a trip we took to a place called Valldemosa, where Chopin stayed for a good while and composed a lot of his piano pieces up there. There we are again. Rory must have been taking this film. Of course, we'd never seen lemons growing on trees before, so it was a novelty to see that and to film it. And oranges too, be good. Back at the pool with Maria swimming, showing off her aquabatics, is that what you call it? There's Colette going in for a swim. Well, didn't she swim well? Maria swimming beside her doing the backstroke. And now we're up in the back garden in Belfast. That's all the grandchildren. This was at Easter. So that's all Bridie and Charlie's grandchildren. And Audrey McHugh was there. That's Gay and Noel's daughter, our cousins. That's Nana is holding Gerard, and Charlie is holding Mark, that's right. This is the Easter egg hunt around the garden. And now we've John's First Holy Communion. That were the Staunton twins. So there he is. And this seems to be yes, Bundoran again. Where else would you go on a First Communion Day? That's the Great Northern Hotel. And there's John with one of his classmates who we happened to meet when we were up there. Maria. I must have told him to pick up the litter that he's after throwing away. So that's myself with Maria and John. And Maria coming down the slide, followed by John. Oh, Maria must have hurt herself there. And now this is Maria's confirmation at the cathedral in Sligo. And I think, yeah, we went out to the Ballincar Hotel, which is no longer there. That's Maria with Colette. And then this is the Girl Guide camp that Maria was on. Oh dear. So this is some of the games that they were playing in the Girl Guide camp. To be in a creeping race. Well, Maria, keep going there. There she is with some of her pals outside the tent that they slept in. This is on Inishbofin Island, where we went for a holiday in the summer of 1980. Myself and some of the men had sailed down with Des Morne, while the women and children drove there and took the ferry across from Clifton in Connemara, well, from somewhere in Connemara anyway. That's Des Morne's boat that we sailed in. That's the hotel in the background where we stayed, Des Hotel. Well, they are raising the sail on the boat. Pulling up the anchor. Was the harbour that Maria and John went out rowing in the rubber dinghy that they're towing behind the boat there, and the tide carried them away. Luckily they didn't drift outside the harbour, and a local boatman jumped into his boat and rescued them. But it was a pretty worrying 5 or 10 minutes. So we were there with the Brennans and the Morans. This was a hike across the island. A bit of rock climbing. Thank you. So this is still on Inis Baffin Island. Maria and there was the wee girl Brennan, I forget her name. But we're going to do some snorkeling. What Rory's photographing there. So there they are going for a swim and a snorkel. That's Rory, I don't know. And that's the end of all the films now. There are no more films left. I forget whether the camera gave up or family lost interest in being in them. But, thank you for watching and goodbye.